song within our breasts. With words of hope and love, the melody blends as we join hands with faith in God above. Dr. Martin Luther King now tells us of this song.
There's a little song that we sing in our movement down in the South. I don't know if you've heard it, but it has become the theme song. We shall overcome. We shall overcome. Deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome. Though I've joined hands so often with students and others behind jail bars singing, we shall overcome. Sometimes we've had tears in our eyes when we joined together to sing it, but we still decide.
Well, if you're sitting on the floor, you'll just be there for a short time longer. Sotema bandani indioli dioli ancorio. Together. They gather as a community under the banyan tree. Sotema bandani, they gather under the tree. And they share stories. They celebrate their ancestors. And they celebrate the stories and traditions and the lessons that unite them as a people. So this song will start with the traditional Malinke West African word, Sotema bandani, and then start telling you the story of Baba Olatunji, the lessons and the words that he has left in our hearts.
So tema bandani dioli dioli ancorio somolu.
So tema bandani dioli dioli ancorio somolu.
So tema bandani dioli dioli ancorio somolu.
So tema bandani dioli dioli.
I'll read from my notes. I want to make sure I give you a flavor of what's happened this past week. It's been an exceptional week. It's almost hard to know where to begin to describe the richness and wonder of what happened at Arlington High School this past week. Every now and then, when you meet a certain person, you know your life will never be the same.
David Moore, one of the art instructors here at Arlington High School, teaching photography, painting, drawing, and been here 14 years. And I was very, very interested to have Winfred Rembert come because I have previous experiences with working with artists that aren't considered in the mainstream art, working with inmates at Bridgewater Treatment Center about 10 years ago doing murals. So I was very interested in the way that he can bring his work to tell a story. And being able to tell a story about your own experiences is like central to art. And so every artist has their own story to tell. And I think every student has their own story to tell.
For our pieces, Mr. Moore had told us to think of a message that had a story behind it or something meaningful about our own personal experiences and stuff like that. So I had trouble thinking of something at first, and then I started thinking about like the future, and going to college next year is like a big deal and stuff. So I decided to do this. And basically what it is Boylston Street in Boston, where Emerson College is. And that's where I'm gonna be going to school. And one of the dorm rooms, the one that I wanna stay in, is called Piano Row. So I also tried to like have the building shaped so that it kinda looks like a piano in the negative space. The story behind it is just like the future and like going to college. And it kind of, I wanted to do it sort of in the style of Winfred. And I like with the colors and stuff, because he used a lot of red and a lot of like deep colors and like the bright yellow that contrasts it. So it's kind of the point behind that.
So the residency included history, visual art, and Medco students, almost 200 students. The art students made art, and you'll see it all around the second floor here. They worked on leather. I was going to actually do a little tooling just to get you, give you a sense of what they were up against. The mallet, one of the tools, but we had maybe a dozen tools to choose from spread around the art room. And the leather. Kids had designed their designs that all came from personal meaning for them. They chose subject matter that had something to do with something important in their lives. And then they created the design and transferred it to leather. Actually, they made the design before Winfred was here, so we didn't waste any time learning how to do the leather part. So what you do is you take your leather, you take your tool, you wet the leather, I'm not forgetting that, and you start banging. And you start designing and texturing and patterning and the whole thing, making your design come to life. Now try to imagine 23, 25 students. So this all started, for me anyway, and I think for most people involved in the project, this all started 2 years ago when we attended the screening of the award-winning film about Winfred Rembert's life called All Me, The Life and Times of Winfred Rembert. We sat through this film sort of not believing what this man had gone through in the Deep South, growing up in the segregated South. A lot of it was about his work, but more of it was about what inspired his work, which were his life experiences, in the Honey Chain Gang, in the cotton fields, in his church, in his town, knowing these amazing characters as he was growing up. Anyway, the most amazing part of that evening was Winfred's presentation at the end. There was a question and answer period. His wife Patsy was there, and his connection with the audience was just unbelievable. So that night inspired this residency.
The first time I saw him, it was on Tuesday, and it was before like first period, because we have homeroom and then we go to first period, and I left homeroom early to go drop off my bags. And he was in the room, and he was the only person in the room, and I didn't go in because I was like, I can't go in there. He's just in there. That's weird. So I just like stood outside the room for about 3 minutes. It was kind of awkward, but he's a pretty cool guy. He's like very hands-on with his teaching. He'll like walk around and he'll check on how you're doing. And I mean, I love our class, but our teachers don't do that. And it was nice to have someone do that. Working with the leather, it's very unusual. I wouldn't typically think of it as like a medium that you would be working with. It requires a lot more maintenance than any other medium that I've worked with. Like usually you can just sit down with like a pen and paper and draw. But with leather, you have to like make sure that it's maintained. You have to make sure that the wetness is level. And if you mess up, then you can try to incorporate it into your work, but it's still gonna be there and you still know that you messed up. So it's a lot more intense than I think any other medium that I've worked with. It's very nice.
That was a pretty cool guy, you know. Real hard to find people from that like era who like still willing to like talk about it, and it was really interesting to meet him and like hear what he has to say, his perspective. As I was pretty surprised at how he was able to convey his emotions so well, considering the fact of what he went through. Like if I were to go through that, I don't think I'd be as open about it. probably a little bit subdued, and I thought that was really impressive. I like the way he connected also with the people he was talking to. So like I like really felt like what he was saying, because like being an African American, it like really applies to me.
Did I really feel uncomfortable?
Not really. I mean, I guess a little bit, because like it's like always hard to hear something that like applies directly to you and someone else is talking about it so openly. That kind of threw me off guard a little bit. Like the only like one of like two black kids in the class, and you know, they don't really understand what he's talking about. But, like being me, I can. And, that was really interesting.
I'm teaching them how to work leather, put things on leather, and that's a hard job. But these kids are really catching on nicely, and their project is beautiful, and their painting is beautiful. And so, I'm just having a ball. Actually, what I'm trying to do besides working with this leather is to teach the kids some history. You know, a lot of kids, I'm pretty sure, don't know about things that happened way back in the 40s and 50s and 60s. And so I'm bringing them that, some history. That's the era that I lived through as a teenager. And I'm trying to give them some things that they probably would never thought that happened back in those days, but it's history. Now that's something I never expected, to get the response that I'm getting. The kids are really, seem like they're happy to be learning these new things, you know, that they never thought that happened back in those days. And they're very questionable. That's another thing. I love questions. You know, when you talk to children, that make you know that they're really paying attention when they ask you questions.
What you got to do, and guess what?